Spencer Lewis for InsideTrackNews.com. We're here at the 46th running of the Snowball Derby down at Five Flags Speedway in Pensacola. And I'm here with a very disappointed Mike Lights Out Bentley, driver of the number 51B. Mike, I mean, your car looked so good. You had it on fresh tires and you were looking good in practice, and obviously just a terrible way to end your day. What happened to the 51B today?
Well, being down here, you need to do a qualifier, and you need a brand new set of tires. You got to get on the car, and you're out there, and the car's on the edge, and you're trying to lay down a lap to see, because you got to make this race, you got to be fast. And so we bolted a new set of tires on this morning, and we got out there and did our warm-up lap, and was up to speed in my second lap, and car is really fast. I mean, we're looking at probably a 69 or 70 flat on with this car. And coming down the back stretch, I seen a super late. He pulled out and he's quite a bit of ways ahead of me, and I figured he'd be up to speed coming out of four, and I closed on him so fast just coming out of four, and had to move. A car was already, you're on the edge, you're sideways and getting on the throttle, and he was just there, and turned the right a bit to get around him, and the car just got up in the marbles and she looped her in the wall, and you know, I went and talked to him, and it was just a freak accident. The timing was just bad all around. He thought that I'd be clearing him on exit, and I thought that too, and I closed on him so fast through three that it caused a bad wreck for us. So
obviously it's early to tell what the damage is. The car at this point is terminal. You're done for the weekend.
We the clip's bent. It was a hard hit. Actually, we bought a new steering wheel down here, and the steering wheel was all bent. And actually, the impact wasn't that bad. And I'm happy I had a Hans device on, because I think we went in the wall at 130 miles an hour, and this track's so fast. And I'm glad I'm okay. I walked away from it, but overall disappointed. I think we had a car that could have ran really well, and I think even a top five this weekend.
What I noticed around this camp is that it hasn't dampened the spirits, though. You guys are still looking like a good cohesive unit, like a good group. Spirits are still pretty high considering all that's happened today.
Yeah. You know, we came down here, first time down here. We're learning experience all the way around, all the guys. And, you know, it is disappointing, but we still got, there's lots of good racing to watch. You know, this is by far the most awesome race I've ever been to, watching these guys out here. This track is so fast, and the Super Late Models out there qualifying tonight was awesome, and just gonna get a few beers of me and be good to go.
Now, despite the fact that you won't get to start the Snowflake 100, being down here and just seeing the way some of these teams operate, has it given you something to sort of build on, and have you seen things and learned things down here that you can put towards your own program once you go back home?
Oh yeah, for sure. Just seeing way Grand American Augie and those guys set the cars up, and the attention to detail that they have, and all in all, I think we've learned a lot from this experience, and I think overall it increases all my crew guys and all the help they get, and all we all learned everything, and like Scott Campbell on tires. You know, he's getting help from Augie's guys, and he's out there, he's staggering tires like a pro and getting us the best sets of tires he can, and Jordan and all these guys is working hard, and Sean, and like, I can't believe the work these guys put in, and you know, Taylor Holdaway and all these guys, and Brandon, it's just awesome. Just these guys, we're a bunch of Canadians coming down and running with these boys, and I think we did a pretty good job.
Now, is the plan to one day maybe come back down and take another shot at the Snowflake?
Well, you know, I'm. If anyone knows me from Canada, I don't give up, and we'll be coming back next year. And the game plan's a brand new Grand American chassis. I think we were down a bit of motor, and we had a stock carburetor on. We're gonna be getting a Ford motor in there and VDL, and I think next year we're gonna show them what Canada's all about.
So you're about 360 days out from making that trip back down to Pensacola in 2014.
Yeah, I think so.
Go ahead and thank, I know you thank your crew, but there's some people back home, I'm sure, that made all this possible as well.
Yeah, I'd love to thank my dad, helped me get down here. I know he couldn't make it, but I know he'd be very proud of me to come down here the way we ran. I thank my mom for all her support. I know she was almost in tears when she heard we wrecked the car, but you know, I'd like to thank all the fans at home for all the support. My Facebook and Twitter's been nothing but blowing up all week. I know I ran through data because it was just going on and on and on all week, but you know. Oh yeah, and also one thing, the car, I'd like to thank imagewraps.ca. These guys did an awesome paint scheme. Everyone down here staring at the car and saying it looks awesome, and if you go to speed51.com, you can vote for me, and that'd be help, because you need a bit of money to go back home.
You need a little bit of gas money, so you're not stuck in Pensacola.
That's right, but yeah, those guys, ImageWraps.ca, Craig and Doug, those guys did an awesome job, so if we can vote and get those guys, get some Canadians, get the Canadians a win on that would be nice. But other than that, I'd like to thank Sean.
The new car is coming.
Yeah, that new car is coming next year, and we'll be top of the charts next year, that's for sure.
There you go, folks. The ego's a little bruised, but the spirits aren't broken. Bentley Motorsports will be back in 2014. Follow him on Twitter, @MikeBentley51. Mike, thanks for the time, and safe travels home, my friend.